Well, hello there. P-Smooth here. Welcome to my super late, mostly spoiler-free review for Star Wars Jedi Survivor, which is available on PC, PS5, Xbox Series X and S, and will be coming to the PS4 and Xbox One. My playthrough was on Xbox Series X. The game was released in late April 2023. Also, just a quick note, the game was buggy as hell when it first released, especially on PC. There have since been fixes, so it does run better. I did experience a couple bugs before updates, but it runs fine now. So, Star Wars Jedi Survivor, the sequel to Fallen Order, which, by the way, was a pretty good game. Should you buy Survivor now? Should you wait for a sale? Well, let's get to it. Once again, we get to walk around in the boots of Cal Kestis and tread a new path throughout the galaxy. When you start the game, you're shown a recap of Fallen Order to get you up to speed with what happened to Cal and his companions in the first game. Fast forward to the present, and we see Cal in cuffs being transported somewhere on Coruscant. You can see the old Jedi Temple in the background. It appears he's been captured by a mercenary group, and they're going to turn him in. Cal escapes capture from Senator Daho Sehan, with help from his new friend, Bode Okuna. We take over from here and follow where the story takes us. Being an action-adventure game, combat is obviously very important. So, how does combat feel? It feels really good. Not the best, but it does feel and look better than it did in the first game. Much better. Of course, Cal is a Jedi, so you'll be wielding a lightsaber and the powers of the Force. When it's time to fight, you'll have a few options on how to combat enemies. There's light attack, heavy attack, block, dodge, and different force powers at your disposal. There are also different lightsaber stances, which play to different situations depending on your current one. The first of the stances is single, which is the most balanced. Then there's double-bladed, which is defensive focused. Next is dual-wield, which is speed focused. The blaster stance, which is range focused, and cross guard, which lacks in speed, but makes up for it in power and defense. Your companions can join in on the action and help Cal out as well. You can even give them certain commands. When you're not attacking, you'll either be blocking or dodging. If you block too long, you'll run out of stamina, so be careful. You want a perfect parry, which refunds some stamina, as well as drains your enemy's stamina. And perfect dodge, which refunds some force. Speaking of the Force, you start off with push and pull. You even get to use your Jedi mind tricks on unsuspecting souls, which by the way is awesome. With every battle you gain experience, and every time you level up you get a skill point. There are a lot of abilities for you to unlock with skill points as you progress through the game, a bit more on those later. When Cal's health gets low, he can have his droid companion, my favorite droid in all the Star Wars by the way, BD-1, toss him a stim, which replenishes some health. When you lose a battle, you lose the EXP you've earned since your last save. You can recover it by returning to the place where you died. There will be a golden beacon highlighting the area. You'll face lots of opponents, ranging anywhere from stormtroopers to droids to wildlife. Boss battles in this game can be a bit brutal at times, and by a bit brutal, I mean really brutal. Timing is everything in these encounters. Perfect parries and dodges are key. Draining the boss's stamina is the key way to stun them and do any real damage. It will be difficult at first, but when you get to hang the boss's attacks and patterns, you'll be good. Just know the regular force powers won't work on these guys, or anything but you're slow. Okay, now on to exploration. The different planets in this game are gorgeous, really gorgeous. Exploring the different maps never seems like a chore. Using your holo map is essential. It helps figuring out where to go in pretty much a breeze. It also lets you know places you visited and ones you haven't. The game rewards you for backtracking to areas when you return with new abilities. You'll find out that traversing the landscape won't be boring. There's lots of climbing, jumping, grappling, ziplining, wall running, etc. It's never boring getting from one area to another. There are some places you will not be able to get to on your own, though. Thankfully, you'll have some help with that. There are animals that will help you to get to higher places, up slippery slopes, and even glide to otherwise unreachable areas. When animals aren't helping you, your companions will with a command. BD also helps you unlock new areas with his abilities. BD's abilities are especially helpful in temples. You will find these by just exploring different areas. You'll face a lot of puzzles when you enter these temples. While you're out exploring, you'll run into crates which contain items like color palettes, hairstyles, etc. Quick side note, you can change Kyle's look on a customization screen. You select different hairstyles, beards, jackets, shirts, and pants. Pretty much his whole look. Alright, now back to exploration. You'll find sense echoes, which give you some lore, and they can also bump up your maximum health. And fractures, which take you to another realm to fend off waves of increasingly difficult enemies. You'll also find workbenches. Workbenches let you customize a few things. You can completely change the look of your lightsaber. That includes the emitter, vents, switch, grip, the pommel, and most importantly, the color. You can also customize the look of your buddy BD. You can switch between different photoreceptors, head, audio receptors, bodies, legs, different color palettes. Heck, you can even make his paint job look all shiny or weathered, which is pretty cool. You can switch between your different lightsaber stances here. You can only choose two at a time though. And last but not least, well, maybe least, you can customize the look of your blaster. That includes the barrel, the body, the grip, color palette, and just like with BD, you can also change the condition. Shiny or weathered, whatever you choose. Now, onto meditation points. At meditation points, you can rest, replenishing Kyle's health, and healing stems, but will respawn all enemies in the area. You can also save your game, change your weapon stances, train, fast travel to other meditation points, and allocate skill points. You can use these points on things like upgrading your resilience, increasing Kyle's maximum health, getting more health from stems, upgrading your current force powers like increasing the duration of your slow power, unlocking new force power like confusion, unlocking new lightsaber attacks for each stand to further your combos, and more. You can also access your perk slots. You can equip different perks to affect things like parry timing, block meter, and throw damage. You will meet a lot of different people in Cal's adventure, and Grease's Saloon is where you'll meet some really interesting characters. While out exploring Kobo, you'll find patrons who can contribute to make the saloon better, like a DJ, someone to tend to the fish tank. Someone can even lend a hand on the rooftop garden. Yes, you can actually garden in this game. You can also collect bounties, which can reward you with perks. Okay, now it's time to wrap this up. So, what do I think about Star Wars Jedi Survivor? To be honest, I think it's a really, really, really good game. It does have its flaws, but in my opinion, it has more pros than it does cons. I was once told by someone that Star Wars Jedi Fallen Order was kind of like a cross between a Souls-like and Zelda. I mostly agree with this, and the same can be said about Survivor. Between a puzzle solving and combat and dying, you will die a lot. It's a challenging game. So, should you buy it? The answer is yes. A resounding yes. Please buy this game. If I could score this game, I had to give it an 8.5. It's a fantastic game. Between the story, which is really good, challenging combat, and exploration, you're getting a solid game that makes it one you shouldn't miss. Well, that's it for me. Thank you for watching my video. Hope you enjoyed my review. I'll see you next time. Peace.